If you have a list like this, so we've got names here, for some reason the spaces are missing. So we could go through it and wherever there's an uppercase, put a space. There's a couple of quick ways to do it in Excel. If you use formulas, it's going to be quite hard. You're going to have to use the case function. But in the latest versions of Excel, all I do is next door to it, column B, so it must be adjacent. I type what I want to see here. So exactly how I want to see it. So you'll see I've just put the space in, same casing, etc. And all I do is I go data, and you'll see there's an option here called flash fill, or you could use control E. So when I click it, notice it's gone, identified the pattern, recognize that you seem to be putting a space wherever there's a capital letter, and then done it for you. So that's a nice quick way directly in Excel. Power Query also allows it. So you'll see we've got the same data here, and using Power Query, I've split it like this. So just to show you how we did it, it's very simple. So you'll see here's the query. So we've pulled it in, the change type they did automatically, and then we've used split column by character transition. So have a look here. If you went to transform, you'll see there's a split column option, and you'll see here we've chosen there where it goes from lowercase to uppercase. So that was the option we chose. And then it's always good practice in Power Query. We've just made everything uppercase just because of the issue where Power Query does not treat casing that's not the same as the same.